Hello traders, FX Pip Collector here. Today is Tuesday, October 8th, and I'm going to be analyzing the pound US dollar, starting on the monthly, working my way all the way down to the 1 hour time frame for the full top down analysis. But first, don't forget to check out my website, fxpipcollector.com, if you'd like to get access to my trade signals, my daily members only live streams on Zoom, and my 34 video trading course. But anyways, on the pound dollar, we definitely did have a pretty strong move down, but to me it doesn't really change anything on these very high time frames. I still think that overall this is going to eventually go up and most likely take out these two previous highs. I think this is a big ABC expanding flat. So taking it down to the weekly time frame. On the weekly time frame, definitely a very strong move down. We have not broken structure on this one yet, but more than likely this move down is probably a wave A of an ABC correction. I think it's going to end up probably, you know, making a several week pullback before it actually ends up continuing the uptrend. So taking it down to the daily time frame. Like I said, there's no actual break of structure yet, but this move down is definitely way too strong to be only a correction to this move up. Most likely this move down is a wave A or possibly a wave 1. I think it's a wave A. Eventually, it's going to go up and make a correction to this wave A, which would be either a wave B or a wave 2. I believe it's a wave B, but for me, it's not important to know the difference between a wave B or a wave 2 because the trading strategy is exactly the same, which would be looking for longs on sort of time frames, just like the trading strategy is exactly the same for a wave A or a wave 1, which is looking for shorts on sort of time frames. So taking it down to the 4 hour time frame, this is definitely still all a series of lower lows, lower highs, as you can see, still all one trend, either a wave A or a wave 1, and this trend does not have to be over yet. There's really no reason why this could make another lower high and just keep on trending down. So until we actually get a break of trend, we can't really say that the wave A or 1 is over, and there's always a possibility that it does go down more before it starts that wave B or wave 2. Going down to the 1 hour time frame, I have my Fibonacci retracement on this move right here. I'm kind of thinking that this is maybe a like leading diagonal wave A, or like a wave A of wave 4 likely. Like this is the bottom of a wave 3, this is an A, and this is potentially going to go up and make an ABC of 4, probably take out Strutzer by a little bit, and then go back down and make a wave 5. Most of this analysis is based on correlated pairs. Most of the other dollar pairs look like they just finished a wave 3, they're probably in a wave 4, they'll likely go back down again for a wave 5 once the wave 4 is complete. For me personally, I will not be trading to the upside. I will definitely be waiting for sorting opportunities because the trend is your friend, and I'm definitely looking for sorts in a downtrend because all the higher time frames are in a downtrend, at least on the daily 4 hour time frame range, which is the roadmap to tell me what to do on these sorter time frames. So don't forget to join my free Discord channel, which is linked down here in the corner, and as always, thank you and happy trading.